So there are many, most of the people take three paths. Three paths is the first path is of self-inquiry. Who am I? Inquire yourself nature. I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect. With that process you start getting out of the ego by inquiring, who am I? Self-inquiry, path of self-inquiry. Or called Jnana Marga. Okay? So then there are people who follow the Bhakti Marga or path of devotion. What is the difference? There is God and I and you. In path of self-inquiry, the focus is on I. Who is this I? You find out that whatever you call as I is not real I, and what I remains is God, awareness. So this is a path where you contemplate and meditate, path of contemplation and meditation. Then there is a path of devotion, bhakti, where you are surrendering I, only thou, you only are there. So in that you path, what is called bhakti, a person goes through four levels of liberation: salokya, samipya, sarupya and sayujya. Salokya means you feel you are one with the you are in the same loka of the divine. Samipya means you are close to the divine. Sarupya means you have the form of divine, and sayujya means you become one. You are not there, only divine is there. So both are same. That mukti in the bhakti marga, and sayujya mukti in the bhakti marga, and atma vichara, both are same. Finally, the idea is to drop the ego. In between the path is there, I and God. I don't want to merge with God. God is there, I am there. It's called, many of the people are in the salokya, samipya, sarupya. So whichever path we are taking, we should more and more listen to that teachings and get the teaching, get the clarity in that particular path. Sometimes you start mixing up these two, get confused. No mixing, just be clear which path you are in and get more and more clarity on that path and proceed.